I am an historian. I am not a believer, but I must confess as a historian that this penniless preacher from Nazareth is irrevocably the very center of history. Jesus Christ is easily the most dominant figure in all of history. H.G. Wells. As the centuries pass, the evidence is accumulating that, measured by his effect on history, Jesus is the most influential life ever lived on this planet. Kenneth Scott LaTourette. As a child, I received instruction, both in the Bible and in the Talmud. I am a Jew, but I am enthralled by the luminous figure of the Nazarene. No one can read the Gospels without feeling the actual presence of Jesus. His personality pulsates in every word. No myth is filled with such life. Albert Einstein. 19 wide centuries have come and gone, and today he is the centerpiece of the human race and the leader of the column of progress. I am within the mark when I say that all the armies that ever marched, and all the navies that were ever built, and all the parliaments that ever sat, and all the kings that ever reigned, put together, have not affected the life of man upon this earth as powerfully as has that one solitary life. James C. Hefley. The man Jesus is many things to many people. He is easily the most influential figure in human history. His words and actions change the course and nature of the society in which he lived, as well as the world at large. Today, over 2 billion people name his name as their savior. It is difficult to imagine what the world would have looked like had he not come and showed us all how to love one another. Sure, very few people actually live this way, but most people at least try. His example sits in the back of all of our minds, whether we realize it or not. We all ask WWJD from time to time. His life is a pillar of Western civilization. In the developed world today, Jesus is still very highly thought of, but he has been tamed in our minds. We like to picture a kind-hearted hippie walking around Judea and hugging people. In an age when much of the church is, above all, just trying to be really, really nice, Jesus Christ in his true royal glory has been largely forgotten. The man spoke with authority, challenged the status quo, foretold the destruction of the earth, and encouraged his followers to be very radical. Indeed, were Jesus and his disciples around today, they would most certainly be on the DHS no-fly list. Several months ago, I had an experience which made me realize that my perception of Jesus was very close to that castrated Jerry Garcia type I described. I prayed that God would give me a deep understanding of Jesus as the supreme ruler of the universe. I know this may sound somewhat like He-Man to a lot of you, but that is how the Bible ultimately describes him. In fact, that is how he describes himself in Matthew 25, quote, "When the Son of Man shall come in his glory, and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory, and before him shall be gathered all nations." In the book of Revelation, he is called King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and he is shown to be a conquering king who returns to do battle with the forces of evil and set the earth aright. It is clear from these texts that Jesus Christ is much more than just another New Age guru. He is our supreme king and should be worshipped and served as such.